Memphis used to be a mecca for amateur boxing years ago.
In fact, our former mayor was
a Golden Glove.
Right.
And I just saw fit that to partner with the Memphis Boxing Group, that we need to rekindle that fire again.
Yeah.
And make sure that we have an alternative for our young people to be involved in, positive alternative.
Yeah.
And we want to make sure that we can do this through boxing. And eventually, we want to have a boxing team that represents Memphis.
That's awesome, at competitions across the country.
That's right.
Well, that's awesome. Okay, so Pete, why boxing? You know, any sport, any group activity can be good for young people, but what is it about boxing that
I happen to be a product of boxing back when I was in high school.
Okay.
And we loved, boxing was one of the biggest sports in Memphis. Boxing was a sport in the schools at that time.
Oh, really?
Yes. And we always had our fights at Bill Street Auditorium. And in April, you could not get in Bill Street Auditorium during the tournament.
Really?
So boxing has been my passion all of my life. I went through a football thing for college and coaching high school and college. And I got into boxing about 25 years ago, and I love kids.
What is it particularly for young men who are just beginning to feel their way into manhood that boxing addresses?
I think probably one of the great attributes of boxing is the discipline that you learn, and the discipline and respect you learn in boxing. You've got to be disciplined to box, not to fight.
Right.
To box, you've got to be calm. You've got to think. And you learn to respect your opponent, because he can hit you in the mouth, and he's going to hit you back like you hit him.
It also seems to me to take some strategy and looking ahead. If I do this, this might happen. Could that potentially help in other situations?
I think it does. I think it really helps there. I think it helps the kid. I think it really helps them to develop more so in whatever field they're going into.
Right.
I asked Jermaine on the way over here, what was he going to be when he grew up?
Yeah.
He said, I want to be a professional boxer.
All right. So gives him a goal.
Right.
So he has a goal, and I told him, you know, the easiest part is boxing. Yeah. Hardest part is training and getting yourself ready mentally for it.
And that involves giving up a lot of stuff that otherwise might be tempting. So Jermaine, what is it about boxing that has attracted you so much, that speaks to you?
I've been ready to box my whole life, but I first started when I was 11 and I got the use of it. So I'm gonna stay till I become a professional boxer.
Good deal. And that also means taking care of your body, eating the right food, not drinking, not getting into some of the other stuff that's tempting, right?
Yes, ma'am.
That's awesome. So what do you say to folks who say, you know what, Memphis has a problem with violence, and they see boxing as a violent sport? How do you jump that hurdle and show them that it's not about violence?
You know, I tell you one thing, Mary Beth, violence is something that we're trying to get rid of.
Sure.
Okay.
Right.
And, you know, boxing is not for everyone. But in many cases, we have young men, young ladies too, that are real aggressive. Mm-hmm. And I think boxing is an alternative for them to kind of harness those skills to make something positive out of them.
Yep.
You know, we have the support from the Memphis Police Department, Shelby County Police Department, and just understanding that this cannot be a burden on city government alone to solve these social ills that we have with our young people. And we want to make sure that we have positive alternatives. You know, the mayor has a passion for our young people.
Yep.
And that's why he support me in my efforts in trying to find different avenues that we can help our young people become productive individuals.
That
and that's so very, very important.